Hello, today I am going to be showing you how you can create a smart collection in bulk by product tags using the Matrixify app. In Shopify, there are two types of collections, so you can have a manual collection or smart collection. With a manual collection, you would manually add products to the collection, whereas with a smart collection, products are automatically added to the collection based on whatever condition you have set. As mentioned in the beginning of this video, we're going to be focusing on smart collections and how you can import them in bulk with the Matrixify app. So let's get started. So as the first step, you'd want to head to Excel, in which case you can see here I'm also in Excel. And this is where we'll be building our file to import our smart collections in bulk. Now you can create the file as a CSV file if you would like. You can even create the file in Google Sheets. However, Excel does tend to be the easiest and most simple option to do this. So in this case, I am also in Excel. Once here, we're then going to start off by adding our column headers. So that's what we're going to do now. The basic fields that need to be filled when creating a smart collection are title, must match, and the rules. We'll start with title, then must match, and then we have three rule columns. And those would be rule product column. The next rule column would then be rule relation. And last but not least, the last rule column would be rule condition. So these are the minimum required columns to create a smart collection. I'll now go over these columns one by one, show you how you can fill them, and then we'll move on from there. Now, our main goal in this case would be to create a smart collection by product tags. And that is exactly what I'm now going to be showing you how you can do. Now, in my example, I'm going to be creating my smart collection based on two rules, so two product tags. Starting off with the title column. Now, the title column is quite self-explanatory. This is going to be the title of our smart collection. I'm going to be naming my smart collection Everything Honey. So we'll go ahead and add that value now in the title column. So Everything Honey. And that is the title of my smart collection. Now moving on to the must match column. In the must match column, you will define how the rules will apply to your smart collection. There are two possible values for this column. The values can be all conditions or any condition. What this means is if the value for must match is all conditions, then the product must satisfy all the rules that you have applied to the smart collection. So let's say we're adding two tags as our rule for our collection. If the value is all conditions for must match, then the product must have both of these tags to be added to the collection. However, if the value is any condition, the product can have either or. So the product can have the first tag and it will be added, or it can have the second tag or be added, or it can have both and it will be added. The product doesn't need to satisfy all rules that we have set for the smart collection. And this applies to any rule that you add, whether it be tags or anything else. The must match column controls how the rule is applied. In our case, we're going to be adding the value all conditions to the must match column as a value, which means the product must have both product tags to be added to the collection we are now creating. So I'll go ahead and add that value, all conditions, and that would really be it to set the value for the must match column. Now moving on to the rule columns, starting first with the rule product column. In this column, we're going to define what product column should be used for the rule. In our case, we're going to be using product tags. So as the value in this column, we're going to add tag. Now this column can have many different values. You can set a rule by product title, by vendor, type, meta fields. I'll leave a link in the description of this video to our smart collections documentation, which will show all values that this column can have. However, in our case, we will be creating the rule based on tags. So the value should be tag. Then moving on to rule relation. This column defines what relation should be applied for that product column and the condition. Based on what you have added in the rule product column, the rule relation value can differ. However, for tag, there is only one option you can add for the rule relation column, and that is equals. So we'll go ahead and add the equals value now. But as mentioned, depending on what you have in the product column, the rule relation value can differ, and that will also be in the Smart Collections documentation, which I again have linked in the description of this video. Now, last but not least, moving on to rule condition. In the rule condition column, you'd add the condition you'd like to set. So in our case, that would be the product tag itself. So I'd want products to be added to my Smart Collection Everything Honey if they have the tag on sale. I will add the tag on sale in the rule condition column. So we'll go ahead and add that. But as mentioned in the beginning of this video, I'd want two tags to be the condition of my Smart Collections. So to do that, I will duplicate the title column and add a second row. The must match value can stay on the first row. That does not have to be repeated. The rule columns do need to be repeated though, as you're adding a second rule to your Smart Collection. In which case, because the second rule that I would like to add to my Smart Collection is also a tag rule, I will duplicate the tag value here. To mention, you can mix and match your rules. So for example, if the second rule I would want to add is based on product vendor, I would then add the value vendor in my second row. But I would like my second rule to also be based on tag, so I will repeat the tag value in the second row here. You would then also copy the rule relation value or add a new relation value depending on what you have in your product column. And in the rule condition column, I'm going to add the second tag I would like. So the second tag would be large. So the way I have set up my Smart Collection now is that if a product has both the tags on sale and large, they will be added to this Smart Collection. And that really would be it. These are the minimum required columns in order to create a Smart Collection. Now you can also add other columns to this file. So for example, if you'd want to add an image to your Smart Collection, you would add the column image source. And as a value, you would add a publicly available and direct link to the image you would like your Smart Collection to have. You can also add a column sort order, which would then show how you would like your Smart Collection products to be sorted in the collection. In our Smart Collections documentation, you will see all of the columns that you can add to this import. But in this case, I am going to be importing with only the minimum required columns, which is what you can see on my screen now. And if all looks good and as it should, you can go ahead and save your file and we can head to the Matrixfy app for import. Here I am in the Matrixfy app's homepage. On this page, you'll be able to see an import section, and this is where we're going to be importing the file we've just created and saved. To do so, go ahead and press Add File. Once you've pressed Add File, you'll be able to see the file we have just created and saved. To import it, you can either select it and drag it and drop it into the app, or you can just press Open, completely up to you, whichever works best. And you'll be able to see the file uploading and analyzing. Now, my sheet has been recognized as Smart Collections correctly. However, in your case, if the file isn't recognized as Smart Collection straight away, you can select the entity that you're importing. So in our case, yes, it would be Smart Collections. Then you'd press Analyze. The file would analyze and your file would then also be correctly identified as Smart Collections. And you'll also be able to see that all of the columns have been recognized as well. So if all looks good and as it should, you can then go ahead and press Import. And now you'll be able to see that our Smart Collection has been correctly created. So if we go to our collections in our Shopify admin, we'll be able to see that our Smart Collection has been created, in my case, Everything Honey. And three products have been added, so Bee Jam, Bee Butter and Honey Pot. And you'll also be able to see the rules that we've set. So if you remember, in my file, I had two rules. One based on the tag on sale and the other based on large. And if we go to one of our products, for example, Bee Butter, we'll be able to see that this product does in fact have these two tags, which is why it was added to the collection we have just created, which is Everything Honey. And that would be it. That is how you can create smart collections in bulk by product tags using the Matrixify app. We also have a great written tutorial on this as well, which you can go through if you prefer a written tutorial rather than a video. I will make sure to link this in the description of this video as well so you can get to it easily. And this tutorial basically goes through everything that I've just gone through in the video, but in written format. And if you have any questions at all, feel free to contact us either via Slack or via email. Or you can write to our fantastic support assistant, MyBar, in the app itself, which will give you real-time answers to your questions. But if you would like to speak to us directly, then you can reach out to us via Slack or via email. We're always on hand to help and answer any questions, queries, or concerns that you may have. But other than that would be it from me today. And that is how you can create smart collections in bulk by product tag using the Matrixify app.